So example number three here, here we have another square-based pyramid. So it's this right rectangle, oh sorry, it's rectangular this time. Pyramid has base dimensions 8 by 8. Oh, maybe not. So it's 8 by 8. If it's rectangular and it's 8 by 8, these dimensions are the same. So really we have a square-based pyramid. And a height of 10 meters. Calculate the surface area of the pyramid to the nearest meter. Now here's where some terminology can be a little bit tricky. A height of a pyramid is not necessarily the slant height. And if you remember from our formula, that our formula uses slant height, not height. So let's look at a diagram or a picture of what this pyramid would look like. So here's our pyramid. This side length would be 8, this side length would be 8, and so on all the way around. But my height is 10, which means this value here of this dotted line that goes up from the middle, the bottom, right to the apex or the tip, that height is 10. It's not our slant height. Our slant height's way out here on the edge of this triangular face. Okay. So what we have to be able to picture at this point, let me back up, so here we go. What we have to be able to picture is this fancy right triangle that appears. If this height of 10 makes a right angle with the ground of the, or the base of that pyramid, and I draw a line to that center, that would essentially bisect these two parts, or this part, so splitting into two equal parts. And it would also, well, if I wanted to, it could draw one this way as well, which would also make this equal parts. So if I'm bisecting that, I'm gonna get this distance being 4, these parts also being 4, okay? Which gives me this fancy right triangle on the inside from the center to the base being 10, from the center to the outside edge being 4, and then of course our dotted line and our slant height. So you can see that right triangle there. Now, what you should be thinking in the back of your mind now, well, right triangle. I know some fancy calculations that I can do with a right triangle that tell me some things. What you should still remember from other math classes that you've taken is that if I have a right triangle, then I also know a formula that allows me to calculate lengths of the hypotenuse and or legs of that triangle. And if I label this with an A and a B and a C, it might prompt you or help you remember what that formula is. C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. The Pythagorean theorem says that the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the legs of the triangle. Okay. So if I know that my right triangle measures 10 and 4, I could calculate this value, this hypotenuse, which is essentially our slant height on our pyramid. So I do that. I use my Pythagorean theorem. C squared is equal to 10 squared plus 4 squared, which is 100, plus 16, which is 116. That's C squared. Remember, to get C by itself, I have to take the square root of both sides. And in taking the square root, I get a square root of 116, or works out to 10.772961. Ah! Where are we here? There we are. Hit the wrong thing there, sorry. 6.1. So there is our slant height. So this is our slant height. And I could take that value and I can put that into our formula for surface area of a square-based pyramid. 2bs plus b squared. This being our slant height, which would be 2 times my base, which is 8, times my slant height, which is 10.772961 plus my base squared, which in this case is 8 squared. Now, you'll notice that I have written in all of these digits. Yes, it is important to carry all of our digits to the end of a question. If we round an answer right now and we round again at the end, we've double rounded our question and we could possibly get a wrong answer. So you need to be very, very careful, be very diligent. It's not that hard to copy an answer from one answer to the next part of the question. If you wanted to, you could also call this the square root of 116, because I know that that's where that came from. Might make it a little bit easier to calculate. And I also do know that most scientific calculators have the ability to carry an answer from one line on to the next by using the answer button. So make sure that you're aware of that and you know the functions of your calculator so you could do so. Now I simply calculate 2 times 8 times 10.77 and so on, plus 64 or plus 8 squared, gives me 236.32527. And in this case, I think the question says to round to the nearest meter. So it'd be 236 meters squared. There's your whole question on one page. So if you need to pause it to copy it all down, there you go. Okay, back in the next video with example number 4.